Thoroughbred Action is presented by Hardacre Farm.
Hello, everybody, and once again, welcome to Thoroughbred Action from Gulfstream Park. Track announcer Pete Aiello getting ready to take you through a 10-race program on a Friday afternoon. Very nice feature race here today. Race number 9 featuring the return of impressive winner Delta Girl. She's the one in race number 9 today. 10 races on the card, so without any further ado, here are the track and weather conditions. We start the afternoon with a fast main track, a firm turf course, and cloudy skies. Temperature here today in the upper 80s. First race of the afternoon on the main track at 6 furlongs. Claimers in for a price tag of $6,250. Scratch the 4, Shere Khan. Scratch the 6, Ultimate Choice. The betting favorite, number 9, Duncan Ben. Racing at Gulfstream. Good start out wide for Right On Ready, who springs out to take the early lead. Moving up on the inside is Saltwater Cowboy. Substrate is at the rail. They're followed by Duncan Bend, and between horses goes Ram Bam alongside Helper Rye. And Cupid's Hit is last of all, and he's about 4 lengths off the lead. They run down the backstretch, Saltwater Cowboy pushing along, Right On Ready. They're in lockstep, a length and a half better than Substrate, then Helper Rye. In the three path is Ram Bam. That'll send the favorite 4 wide with Duncan Bend. Now Castillo gets out of there with Ram Bam, so Duncan Bend is 3 wide in third. And at the back of the pack is Cupid's Hit as they round the far turn. They went 22-3 for the opening quarter speed. Right On Ready puts away Saltwater Cowboy at the 5/16 and has 4 lengths to work with over third running Helper Rye. The whip is out in earnest on Duncan Bend. He's making no ground as they come past the quarter mile pole. Right On Ready, the one to beat, straightens for the drive on a 2.5 length lead. Saltwater Cowboy tips back to the outside and is back for more second. Then third is Helper Rye with an 1/8 of a mile to go. Right On Ready trying to seal the deal. Saltwater Cowboy is a stubborn foe today, but Right On Ready still there. Saltwater Cowboy with a late push on the outside. Right On Ready, Saltwater Cowboy, Right On Ready. Right On Ready by a neck from Saltwater Cowboy. Third in was Helper Rye and 1/10-4. Second choice in the wagering, Right On Ready took charge turning for home and held off a stubborn Saltwater Cowboy to prevail in the opener. For owners Rita Walder and Aventura Stable, Peter Walder the winning trainer, Amisael Jaramillo on board for the winning ride. Second race of the day at 5 furlongs over the turf course. Maiden Claimers in for a $20,000 price tag. Scratch the 1, Platinum Band. Odds On Choice heavily favored. Number 3, Perhaps Some Drama. And they're off. From the center, Idealism gets the first call. Perhaps Some Drama comes away with speed. She'll land second. From the outside, Indominus is away racing in third. They've put 4 on Congrella, then Fist Bump and Card Spun. Down the backstretch and moving to the far turn, and loose up top Idealism by a length and a quarter. Off the fence, Perhaps Some Drama races in the clear from second, and Dominus is third. From fourth is Congrella, a length and a half in front of Fist Bump, and trailing is Card Spun. 6 lengths from first to last with less than 3 furlongs to go. Idealism trying to repel the challenge from the heavy favorite Perhaps Some Drama. These two have gone 3 better than Indominus and Congrella. Then comes Fist Bump as they turn for home. The whip is out on Perhaps Some Drama. Idealism cuts the corner and maintains the lead. Perhaps Some Drama tries to make ground. Lots of drama here with the heavy favorite still 2 lengths down at the furlong pole. Idealism is still there in front by 3. Perhaps Some Drama is defeated today. Idealism coast to coast. Perhaps Some Drama second. Card Spun third. Then Fist Bump and Indominus in 56-3.
Number 5, Idealism springs the upset as she sprung out on top and had enough in reserve to hold off the charge from Perhaps Some Drama under jockey Jose Alvarez for trainer Michael Yates and Shady Brook Farm. Don't go away. More great racing action from Gulfstream right after this. Today's third race at 5 furlongs over the main track. Maiden Claimers in for a price tag of $50,000. These are 2-year-olds with a field of 8. The Odds On Choice at post time, number 3, Dazzling Dixie.
And they're off. Stumbling badly at the beginning was Tiz Taken Back. It was a quick start inside for Stormy Embrace, who wins the start. The favorite Dazzling Dixie comes away racing in second. Porridge is out of there in third. From fourth, that's Peggy's Music Maker, about five lengths off the lead and two lengths clear of Macy's Hideaway. Then comes Cootie Alert and Scrap the Mandate. And after making a mess of the start, Tis Taken Back is the trailer. Around the far turn, three furlongs left to go, and with the lead, it's Stormy Embrace and Tyler Gaffleone by a neck. Porridge is three wide second. From third, that's Dazzling Dixie. It's a stretch of three to Peggy's Music Maker, trying to run on from fourth. Three better than Cootie Alert, then Scrap the Mandate as they run past the quarter mile pole. Opening up now is Stormy Embrace. Stormy Embrace cuts the corner and widens the advantage. The battle's on for the Miners. Peggy's Music Maker's doing some work from the back. Inside Dazzling Dixie, then Porridge, but huge performance today from Stormy Embrace, and Stormy Embrace is on his way to an easy win. She won it by six or seven. Scrap the Mandate ran on well to be second, from Peggy's Music Maker third, and 58 and three.
Very impressive debut run in today's third race. The daughter of Circular Key, number one, Stormy Embrace, pulls clear for an easy victory under jockey Tyler Gaffleone, for trainer Kathleen O'Connell and owners Matalona Thoroughbreds. Today's fourth race is on turf at five furlongs, starter allowance optional claiming event. Scratch number three, Very Few Details. A field of seven went postward. The favorite was outside. Number eight, I Will Be Free.
And they're off. Picture perfect beginning. They all broke as one. Starship Amanda heading off for the early lead. Lady Master is showing speed from second. World Gone Right will come away in the top flight. She'll land third. They're followed by Ghost of Anapa and I Will Be Free. Three better than Vera's Finally, and trailing the field is Poison Art. They speed into the far turn. Starship Amanda in the two path toward the inside Lady Master. Their heads apart. From third, it's World Gone Right. Ghost of Anapa in range today for jockey Miguel Vasquez. Fourth, ahead better than the outside running I Will Be Free. She's favored, covering ground but moving up. It's a stretch of two now to the two at the back, Vera's Finally and Poison Art. Everybody in with a chance here as they run for the top of the stretch. Starship Amanda trying to continue her winning streak. I Will Be Free issues the challenge on the outside second, and down the center, Poison Art is finishing with good-looking energy. Lady Master's off cover for a renewed run. Inside that final furlong, I Will Be Free has the lead. Poison Art continues to charge, and Lady Master's up the inside. It will be I Will Be Free to win it. I Will Be Free won it from Poison Art second, and third was Lady Master in 56 and one.
Tyler Gaffleone gets back-to-back riding victories on the Friday program as number eight, I Will Be Free, holds on to win it for trainer David Braddy and owner's Champion Equine. Six, Poison Art finished well from the back to get second in front of one, Lady Master, who was third. Number four, Ghost of Anapa, completes the super. Fifth race of the afternoon starts the 20-cent Rainbow Six. These are maiden claimers at 5.5 furlongs, in for a $16,000 price tag. Scratch number three, Lady Shella. It's a field of nine. The betting favorite from the rail, Israel's Dream.
From the inside, Cabinet wins the break and tries to establish the lead. Here's the favorite, Israel's Dream, moving out the rail. Miss B and Deddy Ray in the center comes away in the top flight. And as they race down the backstretch, these three have gone four lengths better than Primordial Girl, who comes away racing in fourth. From the center now, that's first-timer Loving Valentina in fifth, outside and Ashley Rose from sixth. Then it's a half length back to the inside, Athera moving up with Gone Rose. And at the back, the trailer is So Who's Back. They run around the far turn, and the favorites have hooked it up. They're going hot and heavy. Israel's Dream on the outside, Cabinet on the inside. They're in lockstep at the 5/16, and they've opened 10 now on Miss B and Deddy Ray, who's left in their wake while third. Trying to run on from fourth is Primordial Girl as they turn for home. On the inside, Cabinet continues to lead. Israel's Dream tried her, but Cabinet re-breaks. Israel's Dream is now second. From the back, Loving Valentina's trying to do some late work down the center of the track and add Thera. Through the final furlong, Cabinet bids this field a good afternoon. It's Cabinet and Eddie Castro moving clear. They'll win it by five or six, maybe more. Cabinet easily. Israel's Dream safe second, going to be very close for third. Loving Valentina's in the picture alongside Gone Rose and Adthera in 105 and two.
Favorites run 1-2 in today's fifth race, but it was the second choice to Cabinet who pulled clear in the late stages to get the victory for trainer Dane Kibiski and owners PTK LLC, Eddie Castro, the winning rider. Don't go away. More great racing action from Gulfstream right after this.
passion for horses and a commitment to breed champions is the foundation of Hardacre Farm. Founded in 1999 by Amy Tarrant, owner, breeder, and trainer, Hardacre Farm, now based in Ocala, continues its tradition of success. From the Breeders' Cup to Gulfstream Park, Hardacre Farm. From the breeding shed to the racetrack, in pursuit of producing the best.
Race number 6 today starts the 50 cent late pick 5. It's over the turf course at 5 furlongs. Maiden Claimer's in for a price tag of $35,000. Scratch the alternates 11 through 15. A field of 10 went to the gate. The post time favorites included 6, She's a Big Machine, and 3, Queen Devil A.
And they're off. Poor beginnings for both She's a Big Machine and Amuse Me. Quick beginning inside for Monogamy, who springs out to take the lead. Queen de Valet moves to be second. Foxy Joxy is out of there in third. From the outside, that's Colonel June, who's racing in fourth, two better than Sierra Love. And cruising inside is She's a Big Machine. She races within 6 of the lead now, and she's 2 clear of the team of Bravo Kona and Shack Up. At the back of the pack are Amuse Me and Silvera. They speed around the far turn, chasing the speed now of Queen de Valet, who bids up to take the lead. Moving to her is Foxy Joxy, while second. On the outside here, Sierra Love tacking on from third. She's a Big Machine is next, followed out wide by Colonel June. Then comes Monogamy, who retreats as they turn for home. Queen de Valet has the lead and moves away by 2. Foxy Joxy is there second. Up the inside, She's a Big Machine. Down the center, it's Sierra Love. But inside the final furlong, Queen de Valet is opening up. Queen de Valet wins and wins easily by 4 or 5 lengths. Second, Foxy Joxy. Up third was Shack Up, then She's a Big Machine in 56-4.
In the words of the great Ron Nicoletti, number 3, Queen de Valet, takes to the turf like a lawnmower run amok and wins for the new connections of Big Lick Farm and trainer Reed Nagel. Edgar Zayas back to the Gulfstream winner's circle for the victory here this afternoon. Today's 7th race starts the 50 cent late pick 4. It's on the main track at 6.5 furlongs. Scratch number 4, Mr. Relly. Scratch the 5, Peace Militant. Off-time favorite was 1, Norman's Hero, under Eddie Castro.
And they're up. From the center, Zach's Image gets the first call and goes looking for the lead. Down toward the inside, both Horner Man and Norman's Hero show speed. Away racing in fourth is Insurance Premium. It's a length back to Union Vow, who sets up shop from fifth, 3 better than Cora Creevy team. Out wide are both Bobby's Lucky 7 and Major Asset. Then down toward the inside, Cyber Josh alongside Limehouse Gas. And it's a stretch of about 6 or 7 to the trailer, Maximian. They run to the half-mile pole, past the half-mile pole, 3 across the track. Horner Man with inside position. Racing in the 2-path is Insurance Premium, 3 wide is Zach's Image. From fourth is the favorite, Norman's Hero, then Union Vow. These 5 are the top 5 here, 3 better than an improving Bobby's Lucky 7, trying to get around Cora Creevy team, followed by Cyber Josh inside Limehouse Gas. Wide is Maximian as they run for home. There's a quarter of a mile left to go, and at 2-1, the leader is Horner Man. By 5 or 6. From second, it's Norman's Hero. Cora Creevy team comes up the inside. Union Vow and the red blinkers on the outside with 3/16 to go. The leader is still Horner Man by 5. Second is Norman's Hero. The battle's on for the Miners, but Horner Man will do it. It's Horner Man and Tyler Gaffleone moving clear to win it easily. Second is the favorite, Norman's Hero, close to 4/3. Give it to Cora Creevy team over Union Vow. Then came Limehouse Gas and Bobby's Lucky 7 in 1:17 and 1.
The favorites run 1-2 in today's 7th race, with number 2, Horner Man, coming away with the victory. Under jockey Tyler Gaffleone, this gives Tyler a riding triple on the day. Winning trainer Ralph Nix, winning owner Rahendra Maharaj. Today's 8th race is on turf at 1 mile. Maiden Claimer's in for a $12,500 price tag. Scratch number 1, Spunzig. All eyes on number 8, Annie O'Schiller, the odds-on choice.
And they're off. From the inside, Niagara Star wins the break and establishes a clear early lead as they come under the wire the first time from True Temptation, who races in second. Then it's Mini, with Island Lights down toward the inside. They're followed by the favorite, Annie O'Schiller. She's third last. Second last is Bourbon Trace, and the early trailer is Book of Bellotto. They run around the first turn, chasing the speed of Niagara Star, who leads it by 2.5. Racing in second is True Temptation, Island Lights down to the inside. Gaffleone has the favorite, Annie O'Schiller, racing fourth, about 4.5 off the lead. Then Mini. Bourbon Trace is second last, and trailing is Book of Bellotto. Into the backstretch they go after completing a quarter in 24-3. 5-2 the price, Niagara Star the leader. Calls her shots by two lengths from True Temptation in second. Island Lights is third. Annie O'Schiller moves between horses. Out wide on the course is Mini. Two better than Bourbon Trace, who has five on Book of Bellotto. Down the backstretch they go. Niagara Star continues to lead it. In fact, she's bumped the margin. She leads it now by four. Second, True Temptation. Annie O'Schiller begins to get offensive-minded. She's third and gaining ground. Mini has covered ground in front of Bourbon Trace, then Island Lights and Book of Bellotto. They run around the far turn now. They went through the opening half mile in 48-3. Niagara Star has the lead, but here's the challenge from Annie O'Schiller. She's coming after the leader at the top of the stretch. Bourbon Trace has made ground for Trujillo. She's into third. Three quarters, 1:13-2, they turn home. Annie O'Schiller now set down for the drive on a two-length lead. Bourbon Trace tries to get after with Niagara Star back third, then Island Lights. Through the final furlong, well, this will be win number four today for jockey Tyler Gaffleone, as Annie O'Schiller strides clear to win it by five or six. Bourbon Trace second, Niagara Star third, Island Lights finish fourth in 1:38 flat.
Well, if you're a member of the Tyler Gaffleone fan club, you're having a pretty good day as the odds-on favorite Annie O'Schiller delivers here today, giving Gaffleone his fourth winner of the afternoon. Owned by Vincent Domino and trained by Dave Fox, Annie O'Schiller won with ease. Don't go away, the Friday feature is next, race 9 in the late daily double from Gulfstream right after this.
Next January, 12 horses, $1 million buy-in for a $12 million purse. It is the world's richest race. It is the Pegasus World Cup.
Ninth and feature race brings out allowance optional claiming runners at the 6.5 furlong starting point. Scratch the two, Blame Dixie. The co-favorites, the comebacker Delta Girl, and the improving Curlin's Approval, Ramisael Jaramillo.
And they're off. From the center, Sherry Angel gets the first call. Here's the comebacker, Delta Girl, moving up toward the inside. And the other favorite, Curlin's Approval, finds her feet. She moves into a head in front. Beautiful Woman is out wide with Sherry Angel settling back to be fourth. Then to the outside and racing fifth, Nasha Nadezhda, then Smartly Agree. Second last is Custom Built, and the trailer is Formal Class. Separated by five lengths as they run down the backstretch. On the outside, Beautiful Woman, and toward the inside, Curlin's Approval. They're in lockstep. Delta Girl gets a sweet spot to run from. She's third behind the speed, followed by Sherry Angel, then Smartly Agree. Stretch of three to Nasha Nadezhda, Custom Built second last, and Formal Class is last with three furlongs to go. Up top, Beautiful Woman continues to tussle with Curlin's Approval through a quarter in 22-3. Delta Girl is third, now into the clear, and has to quicken up after a 45-2 half mile. Whip is out on Delta Girl, trying to get to the leader, Curlin's Approval. From the back, Smartly Agree looks for clear racetrack. She's now secured it, and she's into the clear. Top of the lane, Curlin's Approval still there. Delta Girl is second. Smartly Agree starts to get to the top pair from third. With time ticking away, Curlin's Approval still there for Jaramillo, and Curlin's Approval starts to pull away late. Curlin's Approval impressive in victory by three or four lengths. Delta Girl saves second from Smartly Agree third, well clear of the others. Custom Built photos for fourth with Sherry Angel in 1:16-2.
Bettors had it right. It was Curlin's Approval who went favored, and Curlin's Approval who delivers under jockey Amisael Jaramillo. Jaramillo gets his second victory of the afternoon. Curlin's Approval under the care of Marty Wolfson for Alters Racing Stable. She takes a good step forward here today, winning easily, pulling clear from the comebacker Delta Girl, who was second. Four Smartly Agree finished third in front of seven Custom Built, who shook loose late and got up to be fourth. Completing the high five was Sherry Angel. The Friday finale on the main track at 5.5 furlongs. Two-year-olds take center stage and race for a maiden claiming tag of $25,000. Scratch 3, The Gift from Haven. Scratch 11, El Potro. Favorites included 12, Bank on John, and 8, The Speedball Papacho.
And runners away. From the outside, Air Drosselmeyer wins the start and tries to establish the lead. Papacho is showing speed. Down at the inside is Vivid Image moving up. Vivid Image will continue to run on the inside, keeping Air Drosselmeyer in the two-path. Papacho is outsprinted while third from Bank on John in fourth. Then comes One-Eye Jet. Stretch of two to Radial Flyer, situated about 7 lengths off the lead. Working inside is Tis Bay Time, out 3 wide, and now on the attack goes Archer 1. It's a stretch of another 2 to Don't Come Knockin'. He'll have to get a move on from there, and trailing the field here is Science to Win. 5/16 to go. Air Drosselmeyer leads it by 2. Back to second is Vivid Image. It's a stretch of 3 to Bank on John. And then Papacho inside One-Eye Jet is starting to move forward for Vergara Jr. as they turn for home. On top, the leader continues to be Air Drosselmeyer. Here's One-Eye Jet off cover and coming on. Down the center, a late run from Archer 1 through the final furlong. Air Drosselmeyer still there. One-Eye Jet is still second. Archer 1 is shifting ground but closing quickly in deep stretch. Air Drosselmeyer Meyer almost there. One-Eye Jet taking a lunge. One-Eye Jet is in time. One-Eye Jet and Octavio Vergara Jr. wore down Air Drosselmeyer with Archer 1 third and 106-3.
The upset was on in the Friday finale with 7 One-Eye Jet up to win it at more than 20-1 under jockey Octavio Vergara Jr. for owners Henco Incorporated and trainer Henry Collazo. Number 9, Air Drosselmeyer shifted ground in deep stretch, which certainly didn't help him. He ended up second from 5, Archer 1, who was third. The off-time choice 12, Bank on John, completes the super. You needed all 5 in the late pick 5 today for $933.45. 4 out of 5 worth $9.95. We did have a winner. We had multiple winners, in fact, in the Rainbow 6, to the tune of $3,353.28 for just a 20-cent return. Means we'll have a carryover going into the Rainbow Six tomorrow of more than $150,000. Well, that wraps up the Friday program from Gulfstream Park. Join us again for a Saturday afternoon of racing. Special early start time of 12:45. 12 races on the card tomorrow. Great action all afternoon long. And watch, wager, and win on opening weekend at Saratoga right here with us at Gulfstream Park. We thank you for joining us. We hope you enjoyed your time with us, and we hope to see you again soon. Good night from South Florida.
Hit the hay.
Hit the hay.
I've been working all day. Hit the hay.
Hit the hay.
What do you say? Hit the hay.
Hit the hay.
Hit the hay.
Hit the hay.
Well, I'm tired. Let me tell you, Jack, I'm so tired. Oh, my aching back. Let's hit the hay.